Hey, Phil, welcome to the inaugural Intelligent Assistance Conference here in San Francisco this week. Great morning for interactions, great booth and things like that. Great buzz around the floor. I really want to ask you, what makes interactions unique? Many of us as consumers have interacted with many of the brands you serve, had really successful, great interactions, efficient, delightful interactions. That have been made possible by interaction. So maybe you can talk a little bit about what makes you, your company, unique in delivering some of these solutions to these brands that we all know and interact with daily.
Oh, great, thanks. And it's great that you mentioned that, because I think one of the nice things about interactions and our solutions are that we get such a positive response from consumers. We're countlessly getting tweets and other comments back from actual end consumers who are interacting with the interaction systems. And the inevitable response is, wow, these systems really work. They work better than they could even had imagined. Mm-hmm. And the reason we're able to accomplish that type of engagement with customers is that we've leapfrogged really what people have been able to do with natural language understanding. And so we've added some really key core technologies that raise the level of understanding dramatically over prior generation systems. And when you understand better, you can engage with customers much better. Mm-hmm. You can engage more lifelike. You can engage much more like an agent would engage with a customer care in a customer care environment. And that's really that level of engagement, that level of intuitive and understanding is sort of the next leap forward. Now we've accomplished this through some very unique core technologies that we've been developing over a period of 10 years or so, and they're mature to the point now where you're seeing it deployed in some of the largest brands in the world, and we're actually doing millions and millions into hundreds of millions of transactions, consumer transactions each year through this technology.
Excellent. Can you talk about some of the results some of your customers have had? How are they measuring results? How are they measuring success? Maybe you can talk a little bit about that.
Sure. I mean, I think the first is that reaction, and we can quantify that in terms of improvement in customer satisfaction and customer engagement. So one of the first things that we measure and show large incremental improvement are those metrics, level of effort. So our clients have seen dramatic improvements in level of effort. So the level of effort goes down for the consumer, and satisfaction scores go up. So we've seen dramatic improvements there. The other things are also the automation rate. So what people can actually engage and perform in self-service goes up dramatically. So we've seen, you know, double-digit improvements in performance, and it's largely because our capabilities are better. We can do more things in engage in self-service, and because we do it more easily, more customers engage. So the combination of those two really provide dramatic improvements in the overall performance.
Great. So what's next for interactions? Where is the company going from here, and what might we see in the future here?
You know, to date, interactions is most known for its voice capabilities. So when you, for instance, call into Hyatt, who's here at presenting at the show as well. When you call into Hyatt and you interact with the virtual assistant that's deployed in the voice world. So where we're headed is to start to move that same highly conversational intelligent experience across channels and across devices. And for us, it was actually a pretty simple move, because our core technology never was voice-based, it was language-based. Mm-hmm. So for us, it was merely sort of changing modalities and doing some things to the platform to expand on the channel side, not the core technology itself. So which has allowed us to pretty quickly deploy in text mode. So you're going to see some pretty major deployments today coming down the pipe in terms of text over web chat, and also SMS and other text modalities.
Great. We'll look forward to those. So Phil, thanks so much for giving us a few moments today, and have a great rest of the show.
Thanks.
Take care.